We always have to wait for that last beat. Welcome, everyone. The music gets you going. The music gets the electricity in the room going. Well, good morning. Welcome to this very special event. Most importantly, this is a day for students to walk across our stage and become graduates of BCIT. But this is also a day for you, families, friends, who join us to celebrate these accomplishments. My name is Alan Waterman. I'm a faculty member of the Broadcast and Online Journalism Program, and I'll be your Master of Ceremonies this morning. I would like to first acknowledge that we are on the traditional territory of the Coast Salish people, which includes the Squamish, the Musqueam, and the Tsleil-Waututh. I'd also like to acknowledge our interpreters joining me on stage today. We have Francois and Simon. A little housekeeping before we start. We do have a professional photographer here with us today from Mountain West Studios. Photos will be taken of each student as they cross the stage, and they will have the opportunity to view and purchase the photo at order.mountainwest.ca. And then you enter the code BCIT2017. We encourage you to take any personal photos with your graduate, please, following the ceremony. It makes it run a little faster. We have less flash photography. Photographers will also be available for individual portraits and with family members after the ceremony. Follow the signs up the stairs to room 3040. There's a $10 cash-only sitting fee for this service. We are also doing a live stream video of the ceremony. If you have someone at home, feel free to sneak them a quick text right now and tell them to go on to bcit.ca to watch the ceremony. This also means there's no reason to capture your own video of the ceremony. The link to the professional video will remain on our website for several months. In fact, I saw some even from last year still up there. So you can view it again and again, or better yet, download it for yourself. Then you've got it for your permanent memories. We want to make this an enjoyable occasion for everyone, so once you've tweeted, texted, talked, please ensure that anything you have that makes any sort of noise is turned to silence during the ceremony. Airplane mode is really good for that. Our participants are about to enter the auditorium. Our piper, Vern Kennedy, will lead our faculty and platform party. Once they're in place, it will be time to welcome our students, led by Donna Mackay, Registrar, and Jennifer Figner, the Education Council Chair. So please rise to greet our processions, and please remain standing until after the singing of the National Anthem. Our processions begin with our faculty and our platform party. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Class of 2017. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the entry of the class of 2017.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the grads are in the house. Please remain standing and please join in with the singing of our national anthem, led by Stephanie Standerwick.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Stephanie. Would everyone please be seated? I now would like to ask Mary Roberts to come forward to bring a welcome from the Coast Salish people. Mary is a BCIT elder in residence, having been a First Nations school support worker for the Vancouver School Board for more than 30 years. She was raised in Musqueam territory, Musqueam community, with a strong cultural and traditional upbringing, and continues to incorporate Musqueam traditional values in her work here at BCIT.
Good morning. My name is Mary Roberts. My traditional name is Swalostanot. My homeland is Musqueam. It is my honor to welcome each and every one of you from the Tsleil-Waututh, Squamish, and Musqueam territory. I'd also like to take this opportunity to not only congratulate all the graduates, but to acknowledge faculty and staff, and also to thank family, extended family and friends for supporting the graduates. Thank you. Enjoy your day.
Thank you, Mary. We're indeed honored to have you here to address the crowd. I'd now like to welcome the Aboriginal Women's Ensemble, McGirl, who will be performing a traditional song of welcome and celebration.
Like to share with you is a Anishinaabe song, an Ojibwe song from Ontario, and it's a gathering song.
Yo ho, hi, yo ho, hi.
Thank you, my girl. That is a song for the heart, isn't it? It just reverberates through here. I'd now like to introduce our platform party. I'll ask them to stand when I call their names and to please remain standing. And please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. Starting with the back row, we have Donna Mackay, Registrar. Timothy David from the Student Association. Carl Hildebrandt, representative of the BCIT Faculty Staff Association. Randy Singer, Associate Dean, Broadcast and Media Communications. Paul Mattie, Associate Dean, or Pierre Mattie, sorry, Associate Dean, Business Admin and Business Operations Management. Susan Burgess, Director, Continuing Professional Education and Digital Arts. And moving to the front row, we have Jennifer Figner, Chair, Education Council and Associate Dean, Accounting, Finance and Insurance. Jack Davidson, our Chair of the Board of Governors. Diana Swain, Senior Investigative Journalist, CBC News, and our Honorary Doctorate, and our keynote speaker. Kathy Kinlock, our President. Bill Dow, Associate Vice President, Student Services. And Leela Dawson, the Dean, School of Business. Ladies and gentlemen, your platform party. I now call upon President Kathy Kinlock for her opening remarks.
Thank you, Alan. Welcome, everyone. I'm so excited to be with you here today on this June convocation, our final convocation of the five ceremonies, and the biggest one and the most important, I'm sure, from your perspective. Graduates of BCIT, you've earned an impressive credential and the right to be excited about your futures. But before you cross the stage, let's acknowledge some very impressive people in this room. Thank you, first of all, to the family and friends who are attending, and those who are not able. You've supported the grads in countless ways, and it's largely because of you they are here. Thank you also to our faculty and staff. Your generosity is inspiring. I know you work so hard to get these students here, and I know how proud you are of them and how special today is for you. Thank you for being inclusive and striving to make the benefits of BCIT education accessible for our students. I actually defy any other post-secondary institute to have a more dedicated group of faculty. If you agree with me, let's give them a round of applause. So graduates, I'd ask that you stand and give a brief shout out to all the family and friends who are here as a thank you to them. Just a quick shout out. If you'd like to stand and do that, give them a big hoop. That's great. I'm glad none of you threw your caps yet. So graduates, I now turn to you. Thank you for putting your faith in us. Thank you for supporting one another and for your perseverance. I hear BCIT is not always the easiest road just hear that. We demand a lot. We promise a lot, though. We promise grads who are adept in their field, yet humble in character. Workers who are collaborative in spirit and entrepreneurial in approach. And you now would be citizens who strive for personal success and hopefully for success in the world. Innovative thinkers, some of you will address some of the biggest challenges we face in the world. With this group of you today and before me, I believe we've delivered on that ambitious promise. Graduates, this is a day of celebration, a time to reflect for a few moments proudly on your accomplishments and those of your fellow graduates as well. I wish I had the time to say a few words about each of you, but I know you want to get out and celebrate. So even though it's a longer day of the year in June, I won't do that to you. Rather, I'd like to take a moment to highlight a couple of student stories. First, I'd like to ask Matt Kinchez to stand. Matt Kinchez? He's not here. So no one wants to fill in for him, right? So anyway, let's talk about Matt for a minute. He's a television and video production student, and Matt recently won Best Video Promotion or Trailer from Broadcast Educators Association of Canada for his original short film, The Black Dot, made with fellow student Laura Kim. So that's an example of what our students do. I'd also like to recognize Hannah Ngochi Nassar graduating today. Hannah. Thank you. Hannah May came to BCIT after completing a double major in linguistics and political sciences at Concordia. You speak four languages, Hannah May, won a graduating student award, and was hired as a journalist before you even graduated. And you're now working as a reporter at CKWX News 1130. You can look for Hannah next to Diana Swain in tomorrow's Vancouver Sun. We're going to highlight her. Just a plug. Thank you so much, Hannah. Jason Ng is graduating today with a diploma in digital design and development. Jason successfully proposed a team project to a group of over 120 students and faculty. His project, a buy and sell app, was chosen as one of 10 out of 50 projects. He's taken that experience, starting his own web and mobile design and development company with another BCIT grad. We wish you all the best, Jason. Well done. Finally, I'd like to mention one of BCIT's stars, Wendy McLeod. Wendy. Wendy McLeod is a beloved coordinator in our own Human Resources Department, having joined BCIT in 2010. She's graduating today with her Human Resource Management Certificate, taking two courses per term over 3 years to get here today. Congratulations, Wendy. Lastly, I have to recognize and want to recognize one faculty member here today who's celebrating 45 years of service to BCIT this year. Rob Nason has been educating students on finer points. He's amazing. He's absolutely amazing. He's been educating students for television and video production for nearly half a decade on the last while. But your dedication is inspiring, and we're going to continue keeping you on because we just want to keep you forever. So thank you, Rob. Thank you so much. Leadership, innovation, skill. These are important BCIT traits. Traits demonstrated at one time or another by all graduates I see before me. Now, before I stop introducing people, I'd like to introduce one more special graduate to you now. Would Brianna Stulick please stand? Brianna. Great, there you are, way over there in the corner. Now, Brianna came here today thinking she was going to have a normal day, but she is going to be your rock star because she will be the last person to cross the stage, and I'm going to ask that you give her the most raucous cheer as she does so. And in turn, Brianna, for outing you like this, dinner's on me tonight, and we'll give you a certificate for dinner. Thank you for being such a good sport. Graduates, the adventure's just beginning. The road doesn't end here, and neither should your education. Whether it's back at BCIT or through another education institution, or in your new roles in industry, keep learning. Read, travel, talk to strangers, and be very curious. And most of all, have fun. You have so earned it. Today marks the end of your current program, but not the end of your relationship with BCIT. We have a large and impressive alumni body, over 170,000 members. Please stay in touch. You have my sincere admiration. Congratulations to each and every one of you and to everyone who made it possible for these graduates to be successful. Well done. Thank you.
Thank you, Kathy. I'd now like to call upon Jack Davidson, who will bring greetings from the board and introduce our keynote speaker and honorary doctorate recipient, Diana Swain. Jack.
Good morning, everyone. It's a beautiful day for a graduation. I'm delighted to be here today to congratulate our grads and the parents, and to commend our faculty and staff on behalf of the BCIT Board of Governors. I'd like to take a moment and recognize those governors who are here today, Jennifer Figner, the governor, Scott McAlpine, and it says Asifa was going to be here, but she couldn't make it. To all the students in the audience today, well done. When you made the choice to come to BCIT, you changed the course of your future. The time and hard work, and I know there was lots of hard work. I'm a BCIT grad, a little before your time. 1969 I graduated. You could do the math, I'm old. The time and hard work you have invested here will open doors. Employers about BC know that when they hire a BCIT grad, they're getting someone who knows how to work, who can hit the road running. Our grads are known for their drive, their talent, their ingenuity, and their ability to work hard. And our grads have a reputation for getting the job done. And now you're grads. Going forward, whichever path you embark on, you will make a difference. Remember that. You're going to make a difference in the future of British Columbia and the people. Remember, you're surrounded by your family and friends who are incredibly proud of you and all that you've accomplished, and want to continue to support you in your life. You have also earned the confidence of your instructors. They know just what it took for you to get here today. Let's have a round of applause for your instructors. Right? Thank you. Years, he's probably as old as I am, maybe, I don't know. Very good. Each of you deserves to and should feel enormously proud of your accomplishments. For the most of you, your time at BCIT has come to an end, but your achievements won't stop. BCIT grads make good things happen all across the province. I believe that BCIT is critical to British Columbia's economic prosperity, and now You are all part of making that happen. I challenge you to build on everything you've learned and accomplished so far. Commit yourself to making an impact, to making life better within your future workplace, within your community, and our province, and Canada. I know you've worked hard, and I know you can do it. On behalf of the BCIT Board of Governors, our warmest congratulations to you and all of your academic and personal achievements. Congratulations and good luck. Because I'm the best looking one on here, they gave me two jobs. This afternoon, I have the really great pleasure of recognizing and introducing Diana Swain. Diana is an accomplished expert in her field, a celebrated BCIT alumni, and today will be the recipient of a BCIT Honorary Doctorate of Technology. That's good. The BCIT Honorary Doctor of Technology is awarded to individuals who are widely recognized for outstanding and sustained achievement in areas of expertise and endeavor. Diana certainly fits this bill. Currently the host of CBC News Networks, The Investigators, Diana Swain is one of Canada's leading investigative journalists and CBC News senior investigative journalist. In 3 decades of reporting on stories across Canada and around the globe, Diana has developed a reputation for compelling interviews and for uncovering stories that Canadians care about. And in doing so, has garnered a number of awards from the leading journalism and professional associations in Canada. Her recent work has included an examination of the way Canadian post-secondary institutions manage allegations of assault on campus. For that work, Diana and her team won awards from the Canadian Association of Journalists and the Radio, Television, and Digital News Association. Her groundbreaking investigation into Scouts Canada won the first ever Canadian Hillman Prize, as well as Prix Juste, Prix Justica, Award, I'm sure I'm wrong, from the Canadian Bar Association. Her look at federal government's handling of warning labels on tobacco products won the 2011 Excellence in Health Reporting Award from the Canadian Medical Association. Canadians will also know Diana from her many years behind the anchor desk in Winnipeg and Toronto. She has won the Gemini for the best anchor 3 times. And was the first woman in Canada to win that prestigious award. Diana's work has twice been included in winning submissions for the Michener Award, recognizing Materius, public service, journalism in Canada. Wow. You can tell I didn't go to broadcasting, can't you? Her work is frequently seen on CBC's leading news program, and she regularly fills in for Peter Mansbridge as anchor on The National. And an avowed sports fan, she has also served as Olympic host for CBC Sports in 2008 in Beijing and 2012 in Sochi. Diana was the recipient of an honorary degree from Humber College, never heard of it, in 2010, but an Alumni of the Year award from her alma mater, BCIT. We are honored to have her back with us today. If you could join me, faculty and graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure now that I bestow the honorary doctorate of technology from the British Columbia Institute of Technology upon Diana Swing. So we're going to go up here.
Thank you, Kathy and Jack. And Jack, don't worry about the speech. Wait till you hear me pronounce some of these names. Well, you can return to your seats, and I now invite Diana Swain, our new doctorate, to deliver her address. Diana.
Thanks, Alan. Let me begin, first of all, by saying that was one of the coolest moments I've ever had. That was, that's pretty neat. So I'm going to gather myself for just a second here and look at my script. No teleprompter, so I'm going old school. I want to tell you, genuinely, what a humbling moment this is for me. From the day that I received the phone call, about 12 months ago, in fact, telling me that I would be getting this honor, it has seemed more than surreal, not least because receiving a doctorate usually means that you picked up a degree or two along the way. I haven't. I owe my entire career to the two-year broadcast technology diploma that I received from BCIT, and that was in 1987. So it was, in fact, almost exactly 30 years ago today that I was sitting where you are now, and quite possibly thinking exactly what you are now, such as, is this career I've chosen actually going to pan out? Is the time, the energy, the effort, the money, and yeah, I had student loans that, you know, seemed big back in 87, the gamble of it all, is it going to pay off? And how are you, as I thought then, how am I going to stack up against those from other schools and other programs? Am I going to be able to compete with my two-year diploma against all those people walking out there with their four-year degree? I remember that insecurity like it was yesterday. So I hope then that you'll look at me as an example of what lies ahead for you. In 30 years, my career, which began here, has taken me all over the globe. I've met extraordinary people. I have found myself on the front lines of history in this country and others. I've worked with the best in my business. I've picked up a lot of awards, some of them tough to pronounce. And I've picked up some wonderful recognition along the way. And at every step of that, I realized that I had the base of knowledge and skills to go as far as I was willing to push myself, and all of it began here. And I'm almost certain that my own convocation ceremony was in fact in this church. So I've been there. I want to say to you today in the strongest terms possible, if you've got that insecurity, and I'm sure that you do, because that's a human reaction, put it aside. And put aside any thought about whether you're ready. You are prepared. And you have a running start. BCIT is today an even bigger and better institution than when I attended here. Its reputation is even stronger, it's more widely known, and it's more admired. And while it's important to me, based on how I felt then, to share that with you today, and it was one of the first thoughts I had when I found out that I would be here, I wanted to convey that to you so badly. What I'm really tasked with doing here today is giving you some advice, right? That's what these speeches tend to be about. And it occurred to me that the advice you've likely gotten so far has come from those closest to you, the people that know you, right? They're your family, your friends, perhaps your instructors. Invariably, though, advice from those closest to us is tinged with some self-interest. So today, I'm here as kind of a stranger to give you advice from a stranger. It is unblemished. I'm the honest broker in the room right now. And my advice to you is this. Your friends and family may tell you, try your luck, get started in your career here, close to home, close to them. I'm going to tell you to move. I know, the parents are going, what? Take away that doctorate. She's not used to it yet. She'll be fine. If you've only ever lived in a big city, go live in a small one. If you've only ever lived in one province, try another one. And I'm telling you, you will find community there because you will find BCIT grads in every corner of this country, big and small. So there's somebody waiting for you already that shares your experience. Speaking specifically to the broadcasters and future broadcasters and journalists in the crowd, remember this, that your credibility as a journalist is going to be about your ability to tell a story in context. And your context comes from having a frame of reference. And that means understanding your country. If you're going to tell people what happened today and put it in some frame that makes sense, you've got to have the experience to tell that in a convincing way. You need to understand your country and the challenges that exist in every part of it. If you want your career to be about telling people about the world, you need to get out into it to places you have never been. Because of Skype and FaceTime, you can continue to connect with family. And specifically to the journalists, I would say it's never been more important, I believe, in my lifetime, or I suspect in yours, to speak truth to power. Journalism is a fundamental pillar of democracy. And right now, in a world of fake news and politicized invective that masquerades as information, your job as truth tellers, and that's what we are, will be critically important. We see examples all over the world right now of what happens when people don't pay attention anymore, when they don't vote. And no society has ever been well served by an apathetic citizenry. So to all of you, I'm asking this, on behalf of me as a doctoral recipient, on behalf of me as a journalist, on behalf of me as a parent and a Canadian, after all that you've learned, all the time and attention and the energy that you've put into that, don't stop learning. Kathy, you took the words right out of my mouth a few minutes ago. Stay engaged in the world. You've been so focused on building these last 2 years. Don't let that energy dissipate now. And that's true of all of you graduating today. Whatever field you've determined to pursue, whether that's broadcasting or business or human resources, understanding your clients will mean understanding the world that they live in as well as your own. As all of you know already, markets no longer exist in isolation, and nor can you. Keep learning about your country, your community, about what's happening, and don't tune it out. You're poised now to go into the world and make your mark, so you can do that by staying informed about the world around you. So, that's my advice. But, like a good student of social media, and yes, the CBC wants us on Twitter all day long, and I am, to the frustration of my partner, Eric, who's sitting here happily in charge of my phone right now, so I can't be checking it while we're doing this. I didn't want to stop with just my advice, so I decided to word cloud. Hip, right? Totally plugged into the talk of today. I decided to word cloud my advice to you by turning to my Twitter followers and asking them to weigh in. I asked them, what's the best piece of advice you've ever gotten? I got lots of responses, and the advices ranged from the heartfelt, pick your battles, always remember that this too shall pass, to the very practical, never eat yellow snow. Truer words, right? But interestingly, there was a kind of a theme that emerged in the responses that I got. People who have been at this business of building their careers a long time, and that's all of us up here, and your parents as well, people that I know who, you know, follow me on Twitter, who come from the world of journalism, from business, from entertainment, from politics, overwhelmingly suggested this, that I advise you to be patient. Some of the quotes, life is a marathon, not a sprint. Yeah, it's cliche, but it's also true as heck. It's the tweet that kept getting favorited and retweeted long after I'd started writing my speech. Because in fact, we've all been where you're going. We were eager to get going, we were willing to put in the time and work hard, but many of us want to remind you to be good to yourself along the way. Give yourself the permission to get it wrong once in a while without being defeated by it. Try not to get so swept up in the pace sometimes that you forget what it feels like to slow down a little. There was some other good advice. Never send an email in anger. Let me tell you, emails are the lifeblood of my business. You send a bad email, that's a headline for me. So take your time with those. In a crisis, take your own pulse first. Calm down. Be the face of calm among chaos. And start your day by rising early. Enjoy your morning before the day gets going and you give your time to everyone else. Now, you might be hearing this and thinking, well, that's fine, Swain. Good to say when your career is already underway, 30 years under your belt, maybe you're already done, you don't care, slow down. That we are just starting. We've put in the long hours and we plan to keep doing it because, of course, we are impatient. We want to get going. We want to pay off the student loans. We want to, you know, buy a car, get an apartment with, you know, get out of our parents' basement wherever you are. And I have someone your age in my basement, so I know. You're saying, you know, we have to, you know, put the foot down, gas all the way because there aren't any jobs out there. We're competing to be picked up by somebody. And I know you've been told that. I know you've been told, you know, there are no jobs out there. And I bet you've been told that more times than you can count. So here is my final piece of advice. Forget that. Just forget it. It's nonsense. There are jobs out there just as surely today as there have ever been. And there's one waiting for you with your name on it. You just got to find your path there. Consider this, when I graduated in the 1980s, Canada was just emerging from the most shuddering recession of its history. How's that for a way to walk out the door? The Bank of Canada rate hit 21% in the 1980s. The inflation rate averaged more than 12%. The unemployment rate in this country was higher than it was in the US, which is really a statistical anomaly. An aspiring broadcast journalist didn't have many places to look, and everybody told me there are no jobs. Where specialty channels dominate the market now, so for instance, think about TSN, HBO, even the Weather Network, they didn't exist. The only TV networks in this country were CBC and CTV. Global didn't even exist as a network yet. There was no internet. I know, right? But for a journalist, that meant there were no online publications. There was no such thing as a blog or YouTube. Freelancing was just not a concept yet. In other words, there was no way for you to get noticed, to get your work out there, to start developing your style and your sound and your brand, unless somebody hired you. And even in that, I found work. Like the woman who was recognized earlier, I was already working when I came here for my graduation that day. I'd been 6 months already in Prince George. I flew down the night before, was here for the ceremony, I was back up because, you know, I got like 10 days off in a year then, and I was using one very preciously. And I had that job, as I know many others here do, and I was speaking with Kathy and some of the others from the executive last night about the fact that 97% of you are going to get work in your field. And that's a crazy number. If you got 97% on anything you handed in, you'd be skipping out to the road. 97% is like the best number you can pull out of a hat. And that's you. That's what you're a part of now. And it's because you've learned the skills that I did. You learned the skills to do the job. That was the reputation of a BCIT grad way back then, and I'm here to assure you it's even truer today. This morning, we are sharing something, me and you, something very personal in this pretty public space. And I really want to thank you from the deepest part of my heart for letting me be a part of your day. 3 decades since I wrestled with what happens next, and please make this work. Will I get a job? Will I succeed at this career? For me, standing up here, this is my full circle moment. And I wish that for you. So I want to tell you to take a deep breath. Take in the world around you. Don't stop. Feel proud of who you are and where you are. Be patient. Be good to yourself. And go make your mark. So that some years from now, probably not 30, you'll be standing here, having your full circle moment, giving your advice to that year's grads. Best of luck, everyone. Congratulations.
Thank you, Diana. I understand Peter Mansbridge is retiring next week in his role as the anchor of the National. Any hints as to who's sitting in that chair? You got nothing? Huh. Eric, how's she doing without her phone? Is she okay? She's working well. Okay. Now we come to that exciting moment when our graduates are about to cross this stage and be recognized for completing their programs here at BCIT. You can see them all starting to file out now. Here's the process we'll be following. The students will leave the auditorium and return through the side door on my left, your right. They will hand me their credential. I will read their name, and then I'll return the credential. You need that back, okay? The photographer will then take a photo as they meet President Kathy Kinloch. So you do not pass go. You stop here to be with Kathy. Then our grads will shake a few hands as they cross the stage, not only Kathy's, but Diana Swain's, Jack Davidson, and the dean of their school. You may also see a few faculty members coming forward to join the line and shake the hands of the students they have instructed and supported over their time here. The special connection between our students and our faculty is an important part of the BCIT experience. This is a hands-on place. As each graduate leaves the stage, they will become a BCIT alumnus or alumna and a member of the BCIT Alumni Association. There's a word we have to come up with that's gender neutral. What's alumnus or alumna? And they will join a global membership of over 170 alumni. You'll be presented with an alumni pin to mark this occasion over on the other end of the stage. We hope that you will wear these pins proudly and keep in touch with BCIT. As Kathy mentioned in her remarks earlier, we want to be sure that all of our graduates, from the first to cross the stage to our final graduate, sitting over there, are equally and respectfully acknowledged as they receive their credentials. So we ask graduates to please return to your seat and, along with all our other guests, continue to be present and recognize your fellow graduates in their important moment. So, my platform party, would you please take your places to congratulate our graduates? And here we go. This is the School of Business. Leela Dawson is the dean. And the Broadcast Media and Digital Arts Program, Randy Singer, is Associate Dean with the School of Business, Business Admin and Operations Management, Pierre Matti, Associate Dean. So this is starting with a diploma, Broadcast and Media Communications, Broadcast and Online Journalism, Program Head, Connie Monk. And up first, Quinn Craig Allen. Louisa Alvarez. Nicholas George Arthur. Tyler Jared Bennett. Graduating with distinction, Kyle Benning. Nicole Chenard. Nicole Chu. Robin Crawford. Luigi Gino Cutri. Eric Walter Dockwitz. You need that. Magna Dillon. Justice Levi Deset. Kylie Carson Edwards. Megan Kathleen Friesen. With distinction, Jacob James Hall. Also with distinction, Caleb John Arthur Harder. And also with distinction, Anissa Hetherington. Again, with distinction, Lido House. Jason Andrew Croker. Siobhan Yasmin Litter. Christine Naomi Madden. Tristan Martin Woodhouse. David Matta. With distinction, Hannah Mae Noguchi Nasser. Nicole Oud. With distinction, Amy Elizabeth Quinton. Tamara Romani. Welcome. Radhika Sikkakane. With distinction, Johnny Smart. Also with distinction, Coey Taylor. Brady Weston Tretanero. Paulina Wu. With distinction, Steve Zhang. Moving on to the Diploma in Radio Arts and Entertainment, the program head is Catherine Stewart. And up first, Sean Badeshi. Kanika Chantel Codrington. Nicholas Blake Chapievsky. Emily Rebecca Chewinsky. With distinction, Jenna Davies. And another, just so we understand what distinction means, all these students with distinction graduate above 80%. Up next with distinction, Justine Lee Davis. Taylor Reed Durgasoff. James Richard Duvall. With distinction, Klein Peter Felt. Evan Ian Gilbert. With distinction, Samantha Carly Gill. Alexander Ray Hamilton. Robert Howes. Robert. Matthew Alexander Highland. Camille Iverson. Mariah Millie Izzard. With distinction, Harrison Mark Jewell. Also with distinction, Chase Stewart Johnson. Again, with distinction, Leo Ling. Shalina Nand. Alexis Otley. Don't you love that mortarboard? Spencer Scott Paul. Lacey Devon Pollack. With distinction, Jeanette Aaron Swan. Kate Victoria Tattersall. Carolyn Rose Thompson, with distinction. Also with distinction, Natalie Tung. Michael Jonathan Turcott. Justin Anthony Stamper Vales. Good. Good to see you. Moving on to our next group of diplomas from the Television and Video Production Program, Program Head Ashif Jivra. Sorry, Ashif. Starting off with Jan Optimus Rosa with distinction. With distinction, Jonathan Alexander Alton. Alan, sorry. It's scribbled. With distinction, Nicholas Roy Barta. Well done. With distinction, Hannah Joy Basuelo. With distinction, Larissa Maria Borden. With distinction, Thomas Borhill. With distinction, Stephanie Ann Berdowski. With distinction, Shane Christopher Brooks. With distinction, Caitlin Catterall. With distinction, Alessandro De Solnes. Leone Valentina Grandi. With distinction, Bailey Juliet Hannaford. With distinction, Loren Carmel. Calvin Himit Kara. With distinction, Barry Kirkham. With distinction, Joel Chung He Lao. Zachary Vincent McDonald. With distinction, Brandon Lee McLean. With distinction, Morgan Robert Miles. With distinction, Marcus William Miller. I, Patrick. Marta Maria Piaschetsna. With distinction, Jan Elijah Gabaton Pilares. With distinction, Hyung Jun Shin. Quinn Gillen Skelton. Yeah. Nicholas Sebastian Sortino. With distinction, Stephanie Christine Tennant. Lamar Townsend. Stephen Valchev. Moving along to the next diploma in Digital Design and Development, Program Head, Ramin Shadmeyer. First up, with distinction, Gerald Alessandro Alvarez. Dominique Patrick Petiol. Ryan James Camara. Jordan Chun. With distinction, Christina Cook. With distinction, Nicholas Alexander Jachevsky. With distinction, Patricia Duarte Einsfeld. With distinction, Cameron Scott Farian. With distinction, Jia Ming Fu. Ricardo Antonio Gomez, with distinction. With distinction, Sandra Goncalves Malberg-Cotrim. Yu Han. Gee, I get a hug now. Wen Yun Hu, with distinction, and not just for the hug. Morgan Houston, with distinction. Also with distinction, Matthew Richard Letty. With distinction, Alan Lim. Elulfaith Lavore. Runjin Ma. With distinction, Aaron Lee Manansala. Also with distinction, Weilang Mao. And with distinction, Anne Margaret Moriores. Evan Edward Meyer.
Mayor.
Mayor. With distinction, Jason Ng. Evan Douglas Simar. Su-Yung Song. With distinction, Kurt Angelo Tadeo. Everyone's in a rush to get across. Curtis Aaron Swee. Gagandeep Singh Turna. Well done. Jue Wang. With distinction, Dylan Warrington. Also with distinction, Nathan Wozni. Rebecca Wu. Yaro. Xavier Zhang. Our next diploma, our next program, Graphic Communications Technology Management. Program head is Wayne Collins. First up, Kyle Justin Chan. Anthony D. Emslander. Stephen Howe. With distinction, Sarah Lee. With distinction, Laura Liu. Alan Lung. Anasu Matangadora. Sharon Zhang. With our next program, the Certificate in 3D Modeling Art and Animation, program head is Ramin Shadmer. First up, with distinction, Keith Leonard Baskook. With distinction, Boyan Dulabic. With distinction, Anil Singh Johal. Also with distinction, Benjamin Alexander Litinsky. Got it. Byron Lowenstein, with distinction. Also with distinction, Bogdan Longu. And with distinction, Catherine Rogaccio. Ronish Ryan Singh. Malcolm Taylor. And with our next certificate in New Media Design and Web Development, program head is Edward Fajardo. And first up, with distinction, Maki Oshawa. And we're changing certificates rapidly here. This is Media Techniques and Marketing Communications. Program head is Paul Sawyer. And up is, with distinction, Andre Lopez. Lucas Santana. Well done, Lucas. And the chairs change again. Now we're into the advanced diploma for Business Management. Program head is Amy Fell. First up, with distinction, Sachin Reddy. Well done, Sachin. Hitomi Kurosawa. With distinction, Eduardo Rafael Sanchez Martinez. And changing diplomas again, this is Business Management 2-year program. Program head is Charlotte Culver. Amjad Chander. Davis E. Chorney. Jeremy Deng. Nema Natalie Espiritu. Charles Atticus Finkel. Maria Hussein. Stephanie Huynh. Christopher Joseph Kadir, with distinction. Dakota Ryan Liberon. With distinction, Raymond Lovisa. Willow Anna Mayer. Dylan Alexander Matheson. Diane Nguyen. With distinction, Claire Taylor. Michaela Elizabeth Vetro. Kong Yang Lee. Christina Wong. Dan Dan Xia. And next up with the advanced certificate, this is Sustainable Business Leadership. Program head is Mark Gittrow. Up first, with distinction, Caroline Joan Teske. Well done. With the BCIT Industry Partnership Certificate, this is Fire Executive Management. Program head is Kevin Wainwright. And up with distinction, it's Captain, right? Captain Ronald Beatty. And with the Certificate Business Management, program head is Richard Miles. And we have Julia D'Souza Viega. Anastasia Efremova. Anna Paula Narcisa Severo. Don't lose that mortarboard. Zarina Rinatovna Takarova. Marcos Quiros Nunez de Miranda. Borges. Isabella Leo Borges. Mari Nakano Takahashi. Regis Barreros Augusta with distinction. Moving along to the Diploma in Business Information Technology Management, program head is Malcolm Ferrier. First up, Francesco Rafael Barellas. Nicholas Ryan Chan. Family's in the house. Luis Lorenzo Manauas de Pat with distinction. Jason Batayan Domingo. With distinction, Jonathan Paulo Morales Espena. Samuel Chung Hong Fok. Ashley Fong. And this is our valedictorian for this evening, for this afternoon, this morning still. Diego Andres Gonzalez with distinction. With distinction, Borislav Horiachkin. Brian Leung.
Well done, Brian.
Shane Thomas Madovan. Bruno Giovanni Manella. Suki Moore. With distinction, Christopher Roach. With distinction, Ariel Scavone Pazvolsky. Jiaying Situ. Rafia Tanvir. She wants to say hi to her mom. With distinction, Aliyah Tariq. Shane Gregory Tolmy. Tashna Meiling Yu. Moving along to the Diploma in Business Operations Management, program head is Richard Fidella. Up first, Jacqueline Allison. Varun Bhagwan Singh. With distinction, David Allen Brett. All of it. Louisa Blather Schmidt, VCC Cabanas. with distinction, Peter Chima.
Don't forget that.
With distinction, Alvin Chen. Cha Ying Cheng. With distinction, Gloria Chu. Sibella Corota Martins. There we go. Sibella Corota Martins. Carla Simeone Eboni. Sophia Guy. Sophia. Syed Mohammed Arafat Hassan. With distinction, Chris Eric Jensen. Nachaya Kong Puk Shat. Ashat. Violet R. Lang. Edwina Seeing Lee. Tyrone Langert. Luella Lopez. Angel Jesus Ojeda. Mark Arthur Panganaban. David S. Sandu. With distinction, Chu Han Teng. With distinction, also Jordan Everett Townsend. With distinction, Jessica Leanne Truman. With distinction, Fei Pang Tsai. Do you want your first name? Harkreet Singh Opal. Delina Vu. Obviously a fan base. Enoch Wan. With distinction, Austin Wilkins. Winston Ewan with distinction. Moving on to the Diploma in International Business Management, Global Supply Chain Option. Wait for it. Program heads are Ron McMillan and Jackie Lee. First up is Nuta Khan Chutakovanich.
Yes.
Yes, there we go. She raced ahead of me. Amanda Michelle Fabretti. Sawyer Lee Moore. Dimitri Skoro. Well done. Tim Soldsev. Well done, Tim. Christian Bradley Steffenhagen with distinction. Chang Su. Jiayun Tan. Andrei Volkov. With distinction, Zibing Wang. Edward Wu. Yuha Zhang. Next diploma up is International Business Management, the International Business Option. Program heads are Ron McMillan and Jackie Lai. First up, Khorshed Alam Boyen. With distinction, Benjamin Flynn. Miranda Goodman. Caleb Liu. Stuart Charles McPherson. Negan Razaghi. Next certificate is in International Trade and Transportation Logistics. Program Head of Continuing Education is Ron Wallach. And we have Lorena Carolina Polito Carrillo. Barbara Rodriguez de Macedo. Ana Livia Silva Arrojo. Sajiko Cole. With distinction, Monica Galarza. Carla Severo. Now we move on to the Certificate in Operations Management Industrial Engineering Option. Program Head of Continuing Education, again, is Ron Locke. Daryl James Holmes. And in the Certificate of Operations Management Materials Management Option, Program Head of Continuing Education, again, is Ron Locke. Shelley Denise Thomas. She just got married.
Congratulations.
Antonio Marazona Mara Sosa. For Operations Management, Quality Management Option, coordinator again is Ron Walk. We have Jana Bolatina. In the one-year diploma program for Human Resource Management, program head is Simon Barak. We have, with distinction, Mandy Buller. Okay. Amapreet Kaur Johal. With distinction, Megan Lappin. With distinction, Deborah Ma. Also with distinction, Navneet Sahota. Now in the two-year program diploma, Human Resource Management, program head is Simon Barak. And we have Amy Chan. With distinction, Tanis Sikoni. With distinction, Jessica Houston. With distinction, Hannah Ishikawa. With distinction, Angela Sophia Cara. Jordan Ray Kennedy Harrop. Michelle Elaine Lenahan with distinction. Also with distinction, Hannah Chan and Len and Lin. Sorry.
Thank you.
Anita Nagla. My Alyssa Nakasone. With distinction, Jennifer Parente. With distinction, Scotty Pimprachan. Justin Quinai Xia with distinction. Brittany Syme. And for the certificate in Human Resource Management, coordinator is Richard Miles, and with distinction, Su Ting Quan. And from our own Human Resources Department, Wendy Ann McLeod. Barbara Pinto de Alcevado Vasconcelos? There we go. Sorry to get that. Barbara Pinto de Acevedo Vasconcelos. Kaline Senara Amorim de Oliveira. No? Jane Miguel de Andrade Oliveira. And you recognize her. This is Brianna Sturlock. And you get dinner out of that too, Brianna. Now I'd invite Jennifer Figner, the chair of the Education Council, to please come forward.
Throughout the year, it's the role of Education Council to advise BCIT's Board of Governors on a variety of educational policies, priorities, and programs. We review new programs and major changes to existing programs, as well as set criteria for awards, which some of you will be receiving later today, academic standing, and exams, which all of you have experienced. Through this, we're involved in many aspects of the programs that you've completed in order to earn your certificates, diplomas, and degrees here today. This morning, as Chair of Education Council, I get to do the fun part. So graduates, can I ask you to please stand? And flip the tassels on your caps to the left-hand side. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2017.
Please be seated. I now call upon Diego Gonzalez, an Information Technology Management graduate, to come forward and deliver the valedictory address.
Wow. Well, we did it. Good morning, honored guests, distinguished faculty, platform party, family, friends. Oh, wow, this is awkward. Thank you for accompanying us on this day of joy. Good morning, fellow graduates. It is an honor to be representing you today. I'm still wondering if there's a Dropbox open for this speech. Maybe there is. I decided to move to Canada and change careers 2 years ago. Looking for a different opportunity and a decision to invest in myself and my education. A decision like that is not easy. But who said that life was easy? Who said that life was not threatening? But isn't so far this ocean, space, we would not have been known anything about them if it wasn't for the people that tried and took the chance. If I hadn't taken this decision, I wouldn't be graduating. I wouldn't be standing here nor looking at the new opportunities that I created for myself and my future. Don't blame karma or external factors, because right here, right now, you shape your own future. The most impressive people in the world are those who work hard to fulfill their dreams. We have to invest in ourselves, and I'm sure we'll make a difference. At an interview I just had, they asked me, "What are you proud of the most?" Answered that I don't like to compete with other people, or at least I try not to. But why? Sadly, when you want to be better than everyone else in the room, subconsciously, we're also wishing that everyone does worse than we do. If someone gets a better grade or a higher pay, we feel like we haven't succeeded. We shouldn't be happy because we feel we're better or smarter than someone else. We should be happy when we help someone do better. Instead, we should compete against our past self, because at the end of the line, we can only win against ourselves. Believe me, this is a great recipe for happiness, because we will mainly depend on our own accomplishments. And when you get to lead people, we shouldn't put people down. Instead, we should be a guide. We should be an example. The best type of pride is the one that comes out of empathy and kindness. And lastly, embrace change. I know you will miss D2L, but it's okay. We'll witness one of the most important changes in history and jobs in everyday life with automation and AI. Invest in yourself, be flexible, but be determined. And no matter what you do, We shouldn't be afraid of failure, as failure is a great teacher for humbleness. And that is the road for greatness. Believe me, the ones who truly fail are the ones who stop trying. And finally, a quote by Gabriel Garcia Marquez. It is not true that people stop pursuing dreams because they grow old. They grow old because they stop pursuing dreams. Find and pursue your own dream. To my friends and fellow graduates, I wish you success and, most importantly, happiness. Thank you.
Diego, thank you so much for your comments. You're inspiring us, and you're an inspiration in what you've been through to get here today. I'm very, very proud of you. You graduate with a Business Information Technology Management Diploma, and that's a long way from culinary arts credential, but then you've come a long way from Columbia, so we're so glad that you've entered into our world. I really credit you, Diego, because it can't have been easy, and from what your nominators say, you've taken it all in stride. One of your instructors tells me that you're not only an excellent student academically and technically, but you're hardworking, and of course, you can see that positive attitude from your speech. Another says you have an eagerness to learn and you welcome new challenges. You've pushed yourself to improve your English and even wrote articles for Link magazine, and they don't publish easily, so it's great. You did all this while balancing a part-time job and a full-time course load and even managed to earn that, listen to this, BCIT International Student Award and the Oracle Corporation Vancouver Scholarship. Very well done. I'd like to close with a comment from one of your nominators. Diego is an asset to our in-class discussions and an outstanding student. In short, he's one of our best, and I have no reservations about giving him my full support for this honor. Diego, you are indeed a valuable asset for BCIT, and we're so proud to have you as an alumnus. Congratulations.
Thank you, Diego, Kathy. Now it's time to celebrate with our graduates. Our processions will now leave the auditorium. First, the platform party, followed by our faculty, and then our graduates. Now, before they go, a couple of reminders. Mountain West Studios will be available for studio portraits of graduates located upstairs in room 3040. Leader Frames is available just outside the hall if you'd like to have your credential professionally framed. I also want to remind you that a video of the ceremony will be available online in the next day or two. Given it's a weekend, it might be Monday or Tuesday. Go to bcit.ca/convocation and you'll be directed from there. Everyone is invited to join us for refreshments following the ceremony. The reception will be held in the gymnasium right across from the auditorium. Graduates, please return to the gowning area to remove your gowns before going over to the reception. And please, please move away from the doors as you leave, otherwise the congestion is horrible. So move away outside the doors. Thank you to all our volunteers and staff for their efforts. And lastly, a note for those who just crossed the stage. You've completed a chapter of your journey. Congratulations. We hope that BCIT continues to be a part of your future as you grow and develop in your chosen field. I wish you all the very best. Thank you very much for joining us today. The processions will now leave the auditorium. I ask everyone to now stand and remain standing until our graduates have departed. Thank you very much.